So, first of all, after the installation, what we need to do, I'm just going to start with the Cassandra installation. Installation get completed. Now, I'm just going to start with the Cassandra. So, this is Apache Cassandra. At first, we need to click on the bin. In the bin, we just need to click the batch file, cassandra.bat. So, I'm just going to click on this. It will start the server. So this is the first thing that we need to do. We need to start the server. Now, the second thing that we need to do, we need to run this SQLsh. This is again the batch file. So I'm just going to run SQLsh, SQL cell. So this is how we can start the Cassandra. At first, we need to run the cassandra.batch. Then we need to run the SQLsh file. Now our Cassandra gets started.
I'm having issues again.
Your Cassandra is working or not?
I can't seem to open the SQLsh.
Okay. So in the previous session it was about the installation of the Cassandra. In this particular session we are just going to start with the command and all. So first of all I'm just going to write the clear screen CLS to make it clear. Yeah. The command that one important thing that we need to remember in the Cassandra, like you need to write the command in the uppercase. If you are going to write the command in the lowercase, you will get the error. So everything you write, you need to write in the uppercase. Suppose I want to see the versions of the Cassandra, that what particular versions we are having. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write so version. This will give me the detail about the Cassandra and all. Like Cassandra version is 3.11.4. Like our SQLsh version is 5.0.1. So this is the command that we can apply to see the version of the Cassandra, like what version is installed with my system. If I want to get the information about the server and all, we can use the command sohost connected to the test cluster at this one is the IP address and this is the port number over there. Now the first thing that I want to see, like how many databases are there? To see the name or like the list of the databases, we can use describe. I'm just going to use describe and I'm just going to write key spaces. It will give me the list of the databases over there. Like we are having the CentOS, we are having the system_schema. So these are the predefined databases and these are the actual databases over there. If I want to write now, we are not in particular database. So at first we need to come with the particular database. So I'm just going to use, write on the command use CentOS, I'm going to write. Now we are in the CentOS database. Now I want to get the detail about the CentOS, like what types of replication factor and everything. I want to get the detail about that. So I'm just going to write describe key space. We are getting each and everything about this CentOS. Now remember, it was describe key spaces. This one is describe key space. This is our key space CentOS with replication factor and class simple strategy. Now this was the table. These are the different table. Every detail is there about that table. It's again a different table. Every detail is there about that table. Again, we are having another table with every details and all. Again, we have some another table with every details and all. So this is how you can get the details of this particular key space Santos. Now, if I want to get the detail of the particular table, like we are having a table called EMP, I want to get the detail of that. So describe command is really, it's a powerful one. Like I'm going to use describe the name of the table, I'm just going to give EMP. Yeah, we are getting the detail about the EMP table. So by the use of describe command, describe is the most powerful command in Cassandra. By the use of describe key spaces, we can see the list of the databases. By the use of describe key space, we can see the list of like the detail about the current database and all. If I want to see the detail of the tables, we can use describe the name of the table. We are getting the detail about this particular table, like create table, this was the command over there, and a lot of parameters are the parameters that we are having. So this is basically the describe command. Describe command is most powerful command over there. Now what I want to do, like if I'm going to run the command, like select star from EMP, if I'm going to do that, I'm just going to write select star from EMP. EMP is the table over there. Yeah, we are getting the data like this. We are having the command called expand. Expand on. Now, if I'm going to run the command select star from EMP, see, this is how we can get the result. At the row 1, we are having this result. At the row 2, we are having this result, row 3 and row 4. If I want to write the expand of, if I'm going to make it expand of, then I'm going to write down the command select star from EMP. This is how the data is coming. So we are having the expand command. Just to, if I want to see the look and feel of the display, then we can use the expand command over there. Now, what I want to do, I want to create a table. So how we can do that, or other than the table, I'm just going to start from the beginning. Suppose the first thing I need to do, we need to create a key space. So how we can do that? Key space means what? It's a database we are talking about. Here the database is known as the key spaces. So I'm just going to write create key space, and suppose I'm going to create the key space by the name of test. Now what we need to put? We need to put the replication detail. So I'm just going to write with replication, and in the replication, at first we need to define the class. Like class is equal to, I'm going to give the class. In the class, I'm just going to use the simple strategy. In the class, I'm just going to use simple strategy. Comma. I need to put the replication factor over there. So I'm just going to write replication factor. Replication underscore factor. In the replication factor, suppose I'm going to give 3, like it will make the 3 replica of this. Spelling mistake is there, like I'm just going to use simple strategy. Simple writing with replication is equal to class is equal to, I'm just going to give like simple strategy, and again I'm going to put the replication factor. So key space test get created now. Yeah, it's get created now. Remember, we need to use the same case over there for the replication factor and for the class. Otherwise, get the problem. And here we are writing create key space. These things will be in uppercase. So this is the thing that we need to remember over here. If I want to get the list of the databases, we can also use the describe. Other than the describe, we can also use the command select start from. We can use system underscore schema dot. We are writing system underscore schema dot key spaces. We are getting the list of the databases. Like test is there, Santosh is there, these are the databases. We are getting every detail. Like class is simple strategy, replication factor, these are we are getting. So this is how we can get the detail of the database also. If I want to make some changes with the databases, the alter command is there. Alter key space. What key space we are talking about? It's a test we are talking about. Alter key space test. Now we are writing with replication. Class is equal to, we can use as a class is equal to network topology strategy. I'm just going to write network topology strategy, and I'm just going to give the replication factor. Like it's 3, it's fine. I'm just going to change the class strategy. Okay. So this is how you can make. If I'm going to use the network topology strategy, in that case we don't need to put the replication factor. So this is how you can make the changes with this. If I want to drop the key space, this is the command. We can apply drop key space, the name of the key space. So this is how you can drop the key space. Now, so these are the details about the key space, like how to create, how to alter, how to see the list, how we can drop, and what are the strategy over there. It's a network topology strategy. It's basically for the network system. If we are using the single system, it's a simple strategy will be there. Now, what I need to do, I need to create some table over there. So how we can do that? If I need to create the table, I'm just going to do that. Create table. The name of the table I'm going to create, like EMP. Under the EMP, I'm just going to use employee number is of type integer, and I'm just going to make it primary key. Primary key is compulsory over there. Always you need to mention the primary key. Again, I'm just going to use like ename, and for the ename, I'm just going to give the text. Again, I'm going to give the I'm just going to give the employee number and employee name. EMP is already exist, so I need to create some another table over there. So I'm just going to create EMP9 with employee number and with employee name. Syntax exception line 2, no variable alternative at input employee number.
You forgot the parentheses.
Oh, bracket is missing over there. So I'm just going to create the table. Bracket is missing over there. Employee number, employee name. This is how we can create the table. At the time of insert, you need to remember one important thing. If I'm going to insert the values, this is how you need to do. Insert into the name of the table, like EMP9 values. I'm going to give like employee number 1, and I'm just going to give the employee number, employee name, like this. Remember, if I'm going to follow the same syntax like Oracle, you will get the error. Always you need to put the column name over there. So I'm just going to put the employee number, comma, employee name. Yeah, it's get inserted. Again, I'm going to insert another value over there. Again, I'm going to insert another value over there. Like, again, I'm going to put another values over there. Like, now, if I want to see the list, we can use select star from the name of the table we are having. Like emp9, we are getting the details. Now, if I want to do, like, I'm writing select star from emp, where I'm writing imply number greater than 2. Now, if I'm going to apply the where condition in Cassandra, something is the different kind of syntax is there. If you are going to apply the where condition, in this case you need to apply allow filtering. You need to apply the allow filtering over there. So I'm just going to give allow filtering. Yeah, now it's perfectly fine. So this is how we can apply the where condition, like select a star from emp9 where imply number greater than 2, allow filtering. This is how we can do. Now, one important thing is there, like, now if I want to apply the alter command over there, how we can do that? If I need to apply the alter command over there, so to alter the command, like, you can also create, you can also make the modifications with the column name and all, you can rename the column, these things you can do over there. Like, what I need to do, suppose I want to add some column over there, so how we can do that? I'm just writing alter table. Alter command is there. I'm just writing alter table, the name of the table. My table name is emp9. So we are just writing alter table, the name of the table. Then we need to add the field. So I'm just going to alter table, table name, add. What field I need to add? I need to add the salary. So I'm just going to put the salary is a type integer. So this is how you can add the particular column over there. Now, if I'm going to run select star from the name of the table, like emp9, as such in the salary, nothing is there. Now you need to do the update just to put the value over the salary. Now what I want to do, like, I want to change the data type of the column. Like, I want to change the data type. For that, what we can do, we can write alter table, the name of the table. My table name is emp9, alter table, table name. And again, I need to put alter. Again, we need to put the alter keyword over there. Alter. And what we need to alter? We need to alter the salary. And in the salary, we are going to write alter salary type. Suppose I'm going to put the text over there. So this is how we can do that. Altering of type is not allowed. We just need to check alter table, table name. This is the table we are having. I'm just going to write alter salary type, and I'm just going to give the type text. I'm just going to alter the imply number is of type text. I need to check this command. I'm just forgetting the syntax. More or less the syntax is same, just I'm missing. Now, this is the table we are having, select star from emp9. Now, what I need to do, if I need to drop the column, so how we can do that? We can use alter, what table is there, like alter emp9, sorry, alter table emp9, and what column we need to drop? We need to drop the salary. So this is how you can drop the column. Now we don't have. So we can apply the alter command over there. And suppose I want to drop the table emp9, we can also do that, drop table emp9. Other than the drop, we can also use the truncate command over there, like it's there in Oracle, truncate. And we don't need to use the table keyword over there, just we need to write truncate emp9. Yeah, it's remove all the data from the table, but the table is there. I want to drop the table. For that, what we need to do, we just need to apply drop table, the name of the table we are having, emp9. So we just need to apply this. So these are the basic operations that we can perform. Now, this is the table, select star from emp. In this emp table, suppose I need to make some updation. How we can do that? We can write update emp set ename is equal to, and I want to put the value Santosh over there, where eno is equal to like 201. So this is how you can perform the update operation. It's more or less like the same. So this is how you can perform the update operation over there. Now if I want to delete, we can apply the delete also. Delete from the name of the table, like my table is emp, and I'm just going to put the condition like where eno is equal to 201. So this is how you can apply the delete command over there. Now if I'm going to run select star from emp, that particular data get removed from there. So you can perform the insert, you can perform the update, you can perform the delete, you can perform the truncate, little bit in every command, the syntax that you need to check, like truncate table, table name, nothing is table, truncate table only. So this is how we can perform this command over there. Now one important thing is there, like suppose we are having the data, and if I'm going to apply select star from emp, I only want to display the two record. So we can apply the limit keyword over there. So limit 2, it's only display the 2 record. So limit is there, this keyword we can apply with the limit. So limit command is also there that we can apply. Now what we need to do, remember one thing, like here we are having the concept of composite primary key. What exactly the composite primary key is, suppose I am going to create table, the name of the table, like I am going to create the table like kp. In the kp I am just going to put the role is of type integer, I am just going to put like name is of type text, like marks is there, I am just going to put the marks is of type integer. Now what I am going to do, I am just going to apply primary key. And this primary key will be based on the role, comma, name. So this is how you can apply the compound primary key over there. This is how we can apply the compound primary key over there. Now, if I'm going to insert the value, insert into kp values, role is 1, like name is this one, and suppose the marks is this one. We need to mention the field name always, role comma name comma marks. That's again the challenge for everyone, like in this software industry always you need to face this problem. Like if you are familiar with a particular syntax and if you are going to change the technology, it's always get the problem. That always we need to remember, like lot of databases are there, more or less the syntax is same, but 10 to 15% or 20% syntax is changing in every database. So that we need to take care, like here always you need to mention the field and all. Again I am going to insert the value, and suppose again I am going to give the role 1, and I am just going to put this, even still it's a primary key, but I am able to put the duplicate values over there. Suppose I am just going to put 2 BB, yeah, I am just going to put 3. So this is how we can apply select the star from, the name of the table. Sorry. Now I want to display only those records where marks is greater than 2000. So I'm writing select star from KP where marks greater than 2000. Will it work? No. What we need to apply? Allow filtering. So I'm just going to write allow filtering over there. So I'm just going to write allow filtering over there. Now it will work. So this is the important thing with the where condition that you need to remember. If you are going to apply this where condition, for that always you need to put the allow filtering. Now, one important thing, suppose I want to apply order by, will it work? Like order by, I'm just going to write order by marks or order by row in DSC, descending order. It is asking for allow filtering, so I'm just going to put the allow filtering. Now we are getting the problem with the order by. Remember, order by command is it's different from the normal table we are using and all. The thing is that when we are going to create the primary key, when we are going to create the table, at the time of table creation we need to do something for this. I'm just going to do that. Like I'm going to create a table. It's already there. I'm just going to change the syntax. So I'm just going to create the table called KP. And the KP I'm just going to put the role is there, name is there, marks is there, primary key I'm just going to mention over there. Now, if I want to apply the filter, then for filter we need to write with color string. We just need to use the keyword with color string. So I'm just writing with color string. And I need to put order by. Order by. And I'm just going to give the order by on the name of the like the field. Like I'm going to put the order by name and DSC. Yeah, now the table get created. What I'm going to do, I'm going to insert the values over there. Insert into KP1 values of field name I need to mention, like roll comma name comma marks. Values I'm going to give like roll 1, name is like this one, I'm going to put the marks like this. Again, I'm going to put some other values like name is this one, and I'm going to put the marks like this. Again, I'm going to put some another values like 3. This is the name, and I'm going to put the marks like 2. Again, like 4. I'm going to give Z like marks is 1. Select star from KP1. Yeah, these records are there. Now I'm going to apply. Now what I need to do, I'm just going to apply like where name is equal to, suppose I'm going to write CAA. We need to apply the allow filtering. Yeah, we are getting this record. Now I am writing where I am just going to apply order by name. Once again, just I need to clear the table, just wait. I'm going to create a table called EMP underscore by underscore department 1. In this EMP underscore by underscore department 1, we are having employee number, department and name. Primary key is based on the department as well as on the employee number. And I'm just going to write with clustering order by employee number and ASG ascending order. Now I'm going to insert the value, insert into EMP underscore by underscore department 1. Values I'm going to give like employee number 1, department is suppose IT, and again I'm going to give like we need to mention the field over there, so employee number comma department comma name. Values I'm going to give like employee number, and the department I'm going to give and again I'm going to give the name like this. Insert the value over there like 2, department name is DBA, and again the name is like this, 3, and again I'm going to put like department name is sales, and the name I'm going to give is. Now, if I'm going to write select a statement, select a star from EMP underscore by underscore department 1, where department is equal to, I'm just going to write IT. We are getting the list of those records where department is IT. See, here we are not using allow filtering. Why? Because we are going to apply the clustering over there. Now, if I'm going to run, like if I'm going to put the values, few other values with the department, if again I'm going to put the values, few other values with this, if again I'm going to put these values, now I'm going to apply the selector statement. See, we are getting the data like this, and by default this data is ordering on the basis of employee number. Here if I'm going to apply order by employee number, it's by default, we don't need to mention that. If I'm going to do that DSC, yeah, it's working like this. So at the time of ordering you need to take care, and where you need to take care. If I need to apply the ordering and where, we need to apply the clustering over there. Otherwise we need to apply with filter, allow filter, with where condition. If I don't want to use the allow filter, we need to apply the syntax like this with clustering. Remember, when we are applying the compound primary key, like we are having the compound primary key, our primary key is based on the two columns, it's a department and employee number. The first key is known as partition key. The first key is known as the partition key. And the second key is known as the clustering key. So we need to apply with clustering order by employee number. So the same column we need to mention over there. If I'm going to mention the different column, it will create the problem. So we need to apply with clustering order by employee number and ASC. And here if I going to insert the values and all, if I'm going to apply the where condition and all, this where condition automatically comes in this particular way, like it's sorted on the basis of employee number in ascending order. But like we are from the Oracle background, so if I want to apply the order by, this is we can do. this is how we can apply this. This is the important questions for you for the interview, because if you search in the Google how to apply the ordering in the Cassandra, a lot of confusions are there. So you need to take care. If you want to apply the order by, you just need to use the color string, order by color string. So this column is known as the partition column. So the data will be based on the department, and this column is known as the color string column. So that we need to take care about this. So now we are familiar with the basic operation like insert, update, delete, how to apply the select statement, how to perform the alter, how to perform the where condition, how to apply the order by. Remember one important thing, like we don't have the group by, we don't have the group functions. These things are not there. Like we don't have the group by, we don't have the group functions and all. So this is only the things that you need to remember always, because we don't have too much options over here. It's clear? Yes, please.
Then how would you use group by, or try to do group by operation if you don't have that?
I remember, basically Cassandra is not for that particular purpose. Cassandra is just for the purpose of the Cassandra is just to store the data in the tabular format. Now, right now we are just storing the structured data over here. Now the thing is that because it's belong from the NoSQL category. NoSQL means what? There must be some support for the unstructured data. Like, suppose in the name, I want to put the two values over there. Like name can be the, I want to put the first name and last name over there. So I want to put the, like right now we are just putting the structured data over there. So if I want to put the unstructured data, for that purpose we are having the collections over there that we need to apply. So other filters are there, other collections are there that we need to apply. Here we can create the functions. Using the function we can apply the group by. Directly we don't have any group by over there. These are the new databases. We don't have too much things to do over here. Only the basic thing is that like you can create the table, you can put the values and all, you can apply the selector statement. Because we don't have the subqueries, we don't have the joins. We don't have. So initially you just need to do the practice with all these command. Get comfortable with this, and after that I will start with how to put the structured data over there. So I'm just going to send you the mail. Yeah, this file will be there. In this file everything is there. Like so version, so host, expand, clear, describe. We can use everything like describe key spaces, describe key space name, describe tables to see the list of the table, describe index, expand on, we can apply. This is how you can create the key spaces, this is how you can apply the alter, this is how you can describe, this is how you can drop the key space, this is how you can create the table to see the list of the table. We are having the compound primary key. This is how we can create the compound primary key. This is how we can apply the alter. Change the type of the column, alter table, table name, alter. You can change the data type of the column, alter table, table name, add. Remove the column, alter table, table name. You can drop the column and all. If I want to rename the column, alter table, table name, rename column to. Drop table, table name. Truncate the table. Truncate user. If I want to insert, this is how you can insert the values. This is how we can perform the update and all. This is how you can perform the delete. To delete the complete record, we can use delete from EMP or imply number is equal to like this. If I want to delete the individual, one important thing, like if I want to delete the individual field, this is how we can do that. Like here we are having the data, like this data is there. I want to remove this. So how we can do this, we just need to write delete the name of the column. I'm just going to write, so you can delete the values from the individual columns. I'm just going to write delete name from the table emp underscore by underscore department one, where employee number is equal to 999 or 1. Some partition key parts are missing, department. Okay. We need to mention both, because both are defined at the primary key. Now, if I want to apply this, see, it's a null. So this is good thing about the, like, here you don't need to apply the update. For this, you can just write down the delete like this, delete the name of the column from. So with the delete, you can apply this. Limitation, no group function, max, mean, average, no group by, no having, no join, no union, no intersect, greater than, less than is not applied on non-index column. For that you need to apply the filter. This is how you can apply the selector statement. Limit we can apply, allow filtering we can apply, we can apply order by, but order by will be based on the cluster column only. How to display the current date? Yeah, this is the command to get the current date over there in Cassandra.